I'm Jamon Jordan, official historian for the city of Detroit. And this is Black History Month. I want to welcome you to some wonderful programming called Undefeated, a look at Black history in the city of Detroit through the lens of dance, music, architecture, spoken word, and other genres. Available on Channel 22 and at DetroitArtsandCulture.com. Please enjoy.
African Americans, as they began leaving the South during what is known as the Great Migration from 1910 to roughly 1970, in 1910, 95% of African Americans lived in a Southern state. By 1970, 55% of African Americans lived somewhere other than a Southern state. We call that time period the Great Migration. And a significant number of African Americans moved to the city of Detroit during that time. In fact, between 1910 and 1920, Detroit's African-American community grows 600%. And so, because of housing discrimination, most African-Americans live in the Lower East Side in a neighborhood known as Black Bottom. Because African-Americans are making pretty good wages in comparison to sharecropping down south and tenant farming, many of them working at Ford and other plants, they're able to have a living wage. Many of them having this living wage begin to open up businesses. Many of them who may not open up their own businesses become customers of other Black businesses. Those Black businesses become a center area just north of Black Bottom known as Paradise Valley. Paradise Valley would become the Black business and entertainment district in the city of Detroit from the 1920s until the 1950s. The area originates roughly in the area where Ford Field, Comerica Park, the 36th District Court is, and where 75 Freeway is today, but that was Hastings Street at that time. That area will have 350 Black-owned businesses either in that section or very close to that section. And we call that the Paradise Valley period and the Paradise Valley area. Hotels, clubs, restaurants, stores, shops, all the types of businesses that African Americans would need, including also churches, civic organizations, doctor's offices, and attorneys, all of them are stationed either in or close to that area known as Paradise Valley. This will be a Black business district. However, in 1949, the federal government passed the National Housing Act of 1949, giving cities money to do urban renewal. African Americans in the city of Detroit call this urban renewal Negro removal, because it is their neighborhoods that are first destroyed and are destroyed most thoroughly. Black Bottom begins being destroyed starting in 1949. And then when the federal government passed the Interstate Highway Act of 1956, they began building the I-375 and I-75 freeway. The mayor at the time is Mayor Albert Cobo, who's run on a platform of segregation. He uses the money to begin tearing down Paradise Valley. Black Bottom is mostly all gone by this point, and Hastings Street will turn into a freeway. The land will be taken by eminent domain or sold. In fact, the owners are forced to sell so that the land can be redeveloped. African Americans will lose this Black business district, and because of property segregation, they won't be able to create a new one somewhere else in the city. But the legacy of Paradise Valley will live on, because the music history, the business acumen will pass on to the next generation, and a large part of what will become Motown comes from that legacy of Paradise Valley.